everyone, Miss Carrie here from Miss Carrie's Creations. Today I'm going to show you how I created a interactive scrapbook layout with 22 photos. Here I have about 70 photos of my daughter and her fiance. These were taken by Charlotte Sophia Photography, and all of these photos turned out beautifully. When you have a lot of photos like this, you try to figure out whether you want to put them on multiple layouts or in a mini album. Today I'm going to show you how I'm going to place 22 photos on a single layout using flip-flaps. I was inspired by a layout found in the Magic Scrapbooking Idea Book. This is an older book from close to my heart. You can find it occasionally on eBay or Amazon. The layout inside was definitely the inspiration for my layout. Now, I do make quite a few changes to mine, but I wanted to make sure that I referenced this beautiful design so that you knew where I got my idea from. Now, I often struggle to figure out which color palettes go together. This is where a color wheel comes in handy. In the photos, they're wearing primarily blue, so I chose some colors that were complementary to that blue tone. So I've picked out a denim mix-in paper, a blue Isabella paper, and a retired Hilltop collection paper. I also have a few Toffee mix-in papers and some Desert Rose pattern paper, which also goes well with the blue shade, and some Paprika pattern paper there. I've also picked out some retired florals and some wood grains, and then I have some pocket cards set aside that match this color palette. Now, I won't be using all of these, but it's nice to have them all set out when I start designing my layout. I have already put together the bare bones of this layout because I want to make sure we get to the flip-flap portion of the tutorial. The background was created using some Yesterday and Today paper, along with some pattern paper strips from our current Mix-Ins collection. I did distress those pattern paper strips using some Toffee ink, and then I added just a little bit of stitching and some burlap ribbon. Now let me go ahead and show you how I saved a little bit of paper when I was creating this layout. On the right side of the layout, the area where the pattern paper lays measures 11.5 by 8. Before I laid down the pattern paper strips, I cut out a portion of that background paper, and this is going to be used on the back of the flap that's going to be on the left side of the layout. I did place both of these background sheets on some white daisy cardstock to make it easier to adhere those pattern paper strips. On the right side of this layout, there is going to be a 4x12 inch flap. I cut this piece of pattern paper from the lower portion of the left page. Now, you don't necessarily need to do this, but this just helped me save a little bit of patterned paper. I also added my focal point photos to that 8.5 by 11 page, and behind them I cut a pocket card in half and placed it on either side of the photos to make it look like one continuous pattern paper strip. The next step is to add my square photos along the base of this layout. These are going to be matted in sapphire blue cardstock. And then they are going to be matted once again in some paprika patterned paper. This is the backside of that square pattern paper you see on portions of the layout. Now, I did distress these also with some Toffee ink, and then I'm going to be placing them down onto the page using some foam tape because I'm going to be creating pockets out of these photos, which I'm going to be placing some tags into. On the tags, I'm going to be placing little quotes from Facebook posts that they've been posting over the last 3 years, and I'll be showing those to you later on in the video. On this 4-inch flap, I'm going to repeat some of the colors and patterns that you see on other portions of the layout. This time, the patterns are going to be vertical. All of the other patterns are horizontal, and I need a vertical element on this layout. So I've added a 1-inch strip of that paprika patterned paper, and then I added a sapphire product strip from one of the mix-in sheets right next to it. At the bottom of this flap, I'm going to continue with my row of photos, but I'm going to use a smaller photo that's been matted in that denim patterned paper. Off camera, I've cut a leaf border using my Cricut machine. This comes from the So Thankful layout in the Complete Creativity collection. I decided to cut it out of white cardstock so that it added a nice texture element, but it didn't add any color to the layout because there's already a lot of color on the page. I also cut out a title for my layout. This was cut from the Cricut corrugated cardstock pack. Now, I did discover that when you cut corrugated cardstock, you need to mirror your images and flip the cardstock so that the smooth side is up. If you cut with the corrugated side up, you're going to end up with some rough edges around your letters. If you don't want to use corrugated cardstock for your title, you could just use toffee cardstock or some chipboard letters you have in your collection. Now I'm going to be working on the backside of that 8.5 by 11 flap. I'm going to be using the paprika heart pattern on the pocket card next to the 4x6 photo. Instead of wasting the entire pocket card, I'm just going to go ahead and cut off the 1/2 inch strip that I need, and then I'm going to adhere it to the left side of the photo. This is a great way to use some of your pocket cards. This pattern is a little bit different from the other patterns on the page, but that paprika color matches the other paprika elements I've already added. You can also use your pocket cards to create small titles or text elements on your layout. This pocket card comes from the Serenity collection. It says, "Happiness is this right here." I'm just going to fussy cut all the way around that little white banner and around the flower, and then we're going to place it right next to the photo. Before I do that, I'm going to add a little bit of distressing around the edges using some toffee ink to match the other elements on the page, and then I'm going to show you one more pocket card trick. This 4x6 photo is going to be backed with 2 pocket cards. Now I want to use the pocket cards on another portion of the page, so I'm going to go ahead and gut out both of the pocket cards so that I have these center pieces to use later on. After I have cut out the centers, I'm going to go ahead and layer both of the pocket cards, adhere them together, and then I'm going to place them behind the photo. I like to repeat patterns and elements on both sides of my layout. By cutting out the centers of these pocket cards, I now have some patterned papers that I can use in another area of this page. To help this pocket card title pop up off the page, I'm going to add some texture paste behind it. Most of the elements, including the background, are distressed, and adding a little bit of texture paste is going to just add to that distressed feel. I'm not going to add too much texture paste, but just enough in both of the corners to help this title stand out just a little bit more. While that dries, I'm going to go ahead and work on the right side of the layout. For the back of that flap, I'm using a 4-inch piece of the corrugated cardstock. This is the same cardstock I used for the title. I've added a couple of pattern paper strips on here and some stitching. I'm going to add a little bit of distressing around that cardstock using some toffee ink to match the other elements on the layout. When this flap is opened, I want to make sure that it looks like a continuous layout. So I'm going to make sure that I lay my photos down accordingly. One of the other things I'm going to do is bring in those pocket card centers and use them on this side of the page. Remember how I said that I like to repeat patterns and elements throughout my layout? I'm going to go ahead and take these 2 centers and cut them in half, and then I'm going to make them look like continuous pattern paper strips behind one of the photos. Not only is this matching all of the other elements on the page, but it's also matching that other photo that we matted with those 2 pocket cards on the opposite side of the layout. Repeating elements or patterns on a layout not only gives it a cohesive feel, but helps to draw your eyes across the page. This stack of photos is going to be turned into a little book, and I'm going to show you how to do that later on in the video. For right now, I just need to go ahead and place down the photo mat and choose one of these photos to go down in the center of that mat. All right, so now that all of the photos have been laid down onto these 2 pages, I'm going to start adding my embellishments. The inspiration for this layout came from that magic book, and it had this title, I Love Us. Behind it, they had some strips of ribbon, and on the ribbon, they had added some decorative knots. I'm going to do the same thing with my burlap ribbon. I've created a couple of decorative knots, and I'm going to adhere them onto the page using some glue dots. I'm also going to add a decorative knot above that square photo on the lower right side of the page. Before I add my stickers and die cuts, I'm going to add a few splatter elements across the page. I've grabbed some of my Tattered Angels Shimmer Dye in a deep coffee color, and I'm just going to splatter it throughout the layout. When we take a look at this up close, you can see that the dye looks like it's a part of the background page. And I love the way splatter looks on a distressed layout. The stickers that I'm going to be using on this page come from the Serenity collection. This came out last winter while I was sick, so I never had a chance to use it. It actually worked out perfectly because the bluebell and sapphire and toffee floral elements match everything else on this layout perfectly. Now, unfortunately, this is retired and you can't find it anymore, but some of you probably have some stashed away and it's perfect to mix in with our current denim and paprika mix-in papers. Around each of the floral elements, I'm going to be using some craft-colored leaves that I cut using these layered leaf dies. Now, when I made this layout, they were available on my website, and unfortunately, they have sold out, but you could also use your Cricut machine to cut some of these out, or you might have some leaf dies in your collection that you could use. I chose to cut the leaves out of craft paper because the leaves on the sticker elements are shaded in a toffee color. So now the leaves kind of look like they're a part of that sticker element, and they also match the craft colored title that I created on the page. I'm also going to add a few more floral elements on the left side of the layout. We have that really large floral element over there on the right side of the page, and then I've added a small flower in the lower right corner of those two photos. And now I'm going to add a third floral element in the upper left-hand corner so that we create a nice visual triangle. This is going to help our eyes flow across the layout. Now, as you saw, I also added a little blue flower in that upper corner and a little saying that says so happy. And I'm also adding a couple of those craft die-cut leaves just to match all of the other floral elements that are on the page. Underneath those flowers on the right-hand page, I added some bits of texture paste, and then you can see I also added some texture paste over on the left page. We're going to be adding a quote there. So now I have three spots on my layout with texture paste. So now I've opened up that left side flap, and I want to add some floral elements around these photos. When the flap was closed, we created a visual triangle with the other floral elements. Now that it's open, I need to create another visual triangle with that really large floral element over on the right side of the page. This is something you need to think about when you're creating interactive scrapbook pages. Not only am I making sure that all of my photos there are not going past that 8.5 mark, I'm also making sure that I still have a nice flow between all of the pages when the flaps are opened and closed. On my Yesterday and Today sticker sheet, I found this quote that says, "Where life begins and love never ends." I thought this was the perfect quote for all of these photos. To help me line up these words, I drew a center line on the page. So you're seeing me erase those lines as I adhere this quote on the page. I've opened up that flap over on the right side, and I'm going to add a few more floral elements. When this flap is opened, we're not going to be able to see that large floral element. And like I said, we want to make sure we create a visual triangle when the flaps are opened or closed. All right, now that I've added all of my embellishments, I'm going to start adding all the interactive components to this layout. So the first thing I'm going to create is that 3x3 interactive book on the lower right side of the page. I have some 3-inch by 3-inch flip flaps. And your photos just slide right inside of these. Really easy to do. This little adhesive strip is going to stick down onto my memory protector, and then the book is going to fold over the top of this photo, and then when we open it up, we're going to be able to see all of the photos inside the book. So real quick, I'm going to make sure that my photo is on the right side of the flip flap, and then I'm going to adhere another flip flap right next to it. So I'm going to zoom in here so you can see this a little bit better. I've removed that backing strip, and then I'm going to match up the two flip flaps together. And you're basically just matching up the stitching on the two flip flaps so we can create this little book. So once these are adhered together, you can see that it's just going to fold over and create a nice little booklet. And then this is going to be placed over that photo, and we'll have this nice little folded book on top of it. I'm going to repeat this process with that third flip flap, just adhering it there to the second flip flap. Again, just matching up the lines on the one flip flap with the stitching on the other. So the flip flaps allow you to add photos to both the front and the back of this little booklet. And I only have 5 photos here, so I'm going to add a little decorative element in the center. I've taken another pocket card and I've cut it down and placed it on some Bluebell cardstock. And then I'm just going to add a little floral element to it, tuck it into that center flip flap. And then I'm going to go ahead and close up this booklet, and it's going to fit right over the top of that photo. And in a few moments here, I'll show you how this attaches to the memory protector. So at this point of the video, I had planned on taking an 8x12 flip flap, inserting that smaller page and showing you how to attach it to my layout. But when I went to put that page into the flip flap, I realized that I cut it at 8.5x11, so it did not fit into the flip flap. So I had to completely rethink how I was going to put this layout together. I honestly kept wondering why, when I cut the other page at 8x11, it didn't quite fit on the back of this page, but it just didn't dawn on me that I didn't have the measurements right. And there was really no fixing this. So I ended up grabbing an 8.5x11 page protector, and I kind of retrofit it to turn it into a flip flap. So let me show you how I did that. So the first thing I did was cut a 10-inch slit into my 12x12 memory protector. When I adhere these two memory protectors together, I don't want adhesive on the back side of this memory protector showing on the page that I put behind this page. So I need to cut this little 10-inch slit to slide the 8.5x11 protector into. On my 8.5x11 page protector, there's the area where the holes are, and I cut angles on that little portion of the page protector so that it only measures 10 inches. Now I'm going to go ahead and grab some score tape and place it along that side of that memory protector. After I've removed the adhesive backing, I'm just going to slide that page protector right into the slit I cut into the 12x12 memory protector and adhere this directly to my layout. Now, if you don't want to cut a slit in your memory protector, or you don't want to adhere anything onto your layout, you can just go ahead and adhere this 8.5x11 memory protector right onto the 12x12 page protector. It doesn't look as nice as a flip flap, but it will work. Now that I've added this 8.5x11 flap on the left-hand side, I can go ahead and open it up and add my 4x4 flip flap. I just need to slide the photo right inside, remove the adhesive backing, and then adhere this right on top of the memory protector, lining it up with that other 4x4 photo. Now I could either add another photo underneath, or I could add some more journaling. On the right-hand page, I have a 4-inch flap, and the smallest flip flap we have is 6x12. So I've gone ahead and I've created a score line at the 4-inch mark, and then I'm going to cut this down and create my own 4-inch by 12-inch flip flap. Now, if you create your own flip flap, make sure that the open side of the flap where your page slides in actually faces to the inside of your layout. If it faces to the outside, it could cause your page to fall out of your album. I am attaching this the same way I attached that 8.5x11 flip flap. I cut a slit in the 12x12 memory protector, I added some score tape on my little flap, and then I'm just going to go ahead and adhere it directly onto my layout. Now, like I said, if you don't want to cut a slit in your memory protector, if you don't want to adhere this directly onto your page, you can adhere it directly onto your 12x12 memory protector. That little 3x3 booklet I created is going to be adhered directly onto the page protector, just like that 4x4 flip-flap I added a second ago. The last step is to add my journaling, and I'm going to do this on these little tags. I cut them out of craft paper on my Cricut, and then I use this Isabella scrapbooking stamp set to stamp some background flowers on the craft cardstock using some toffee ink. On each of these tags is a little card. These cards have sentiments on them that I took from their Facebook posts. They're either Valentine's wishes or little poems or just those simple I love yous that they posted back and forth. I printed these on my printer and then I just cut them out and they're going to be adhered to each one of the tags. On the top of the tag, I'm going to use some of that burlap ribbon I used on other parts of the layout. To help hold the tops of the ribbon together, I'm just going to add a little micro glue dot between the two layers, and then I'm going to use some brown twine, wrap it around the top of the ribbon to create a nice little decorative element, and then I'm just going to go ahead and tuck these tags into the pockets I created behind those 3x3 photos. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at this completed layout with all its interactive elements. So I've done my best to turn the lights down just a little bit so we don't end up with a lot of glare against these page protectors. I want to be able to show you how all of these elements work together. So not only have I added the little tags with all of the journaling that can be pulled out of the photograph pockets, I've also created flaps on both sides of the layout. So if we bring over this left page, we're going to be able to open up this 8.5x11 flap. You're going to see even more photos on the layout. Now you might have noticed that the tag shapes were a little bit different. The ones that have the more square shape are his quotes, and the other tags are her quotes. So now we're going to go ahead and close this side of the page, and we're going to bring over the right side. On this side, I have some more of those pocket photos, and then I created that little 4-inch flap that opens and a little 3x3 booklet that can be opened. So you can open it over to the right and see 3 photos, or you can open it up to the left and see 3 photos and that fun little pocket card. When all of the interactive elements are closed and you place these two pages side by side, it looks just like a double page scrapbook layout in your album. Adding the interactive elements to this layout allowed me to add 22 photos from that photo shoot on my scrapbook page. I want to thank Charlotte Sophia Photography for such wonderful photos, and I want to thank you for joining me for another scrapbooking tutorial. I hope that this gave you a few new ideas that you plan on using on your future scrapbook pages. If you would like to see more of my scrapbooking layouts, you can go ahead and click on that collection icon above. While you're at it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any future video tutorials. I hope you have a wonderful week. I can't wait to see what you create.